watching my channel. Thank you, and I'm hoping you've already seen a few Back to the Basics series videos. If you've not, and you're new, hey, thank you so much for dropping in and saying hi. I hope you like what I have around. I hope you've been binge watching my videos. We are discussing color correcting today. I'm not going to cover all of it. It is a huge, huge thing. And yes, I know it can seem really daunting. Color correcting seems like this trend that everyone seems to be doing. And you're just like, how do I even get the hang of it? Don't worry. First of all, it's not difficult, guys. And I must, because this is a Back to the Basics video. Makeup has no rules. So you can do what you like. These are just things that can enhance your makeup and the final look. So just kind of like work with it, play with it. It's a lot of fun. I'll just quickly take you through the basics of color correcting. You will essentially broadly find these three shades of correctors: orange, green, and purple. Now, orange is usually used on Indian skin tones. That is the one color that you will see a lot of people use. It is because it offsets blue or purple undertones. And that is, you know, since we do have a lot of blue or purple undertones in our skin, that's the corrector that you will see being used the most. Green is used to hide redness. Now, if you have a pimple or angry red marks due to something, that would be the shade that you should go with. If you have acne prone skin and you want to, you know, sort of get a clearer base, that might, green might be the color to go to. And purple is to offset orange, obviously, because we use orange to offset purple, so, you know. So, purple is to offset orange, green, oranges, and peachy red undertones. It's not as commonly used here. Of course, some people who do have extreme redness do tend to go with purple. Guys, the deal with correction is, if it doesn't require correction, don't touch it. Don't put in extra corrector, don't put in a lot of layers of makeup, because makeup is supposed to look natural. It's supposed to be a better version of you, not just like a completely different version of you, yeah? It's just you, which is prettier. That's it. It's not supposed to change your face, make you 3 degrees fairer. I don't know. It's not supposed to do that. Yeah, makeup's not supposed... Well, that's the philosophy I subscribe to. Makeup's just making you look like a better version of yourself. So if you don't need correction, or if you think that area doesn't need correction, don't apply corrector. It's fine. It's not make or break. Yeah, guys, that's what color correcting is about. Offsetting the tone that is in your skin so that you get a more natural base, and your foundation comes the right shade on your skin, your concealer looks the right shade, all of those things. I do show you in this demo how I color correct personally and how I apply my concealer. I only use it under my eyes, so that's what I show you. And if you have any questions or comments, or if you know have anything that you would like to ask me, which is a question basically, just put it in the comments and I promise I'll reply. I am going to be using an orange tone corrector. This is from Kryolan, and it's the shade D30. This one goes perfectly under my eyes and gives me the amount of coverage that I need. So I'm going with this one. Guys, this one's kind of epic because it is so pigmented and it's so buildable, and it's 350 rupees. So guys, this is just a deal you cannot miss. Now, you already, obviously, and already, I assume, will have moisturized your face and moisturized the under eye area. You want to wait for the moisture to be kind of sit into your skin and soak into your skin. I mean, your corrector will move if you've still got product there. So wait for it to all sink in. You do have time. Now, I know that a lot of people do correction, then do foundation. But I have put my foundation on first, and then I'm going in for my correction. That's because, like I've said in a Back to the Basics video before, foundation does offer a certain degree of coverage. Right now, then I will go on with my corrector. So I'm just going to take it on my brush. This is the Pack 361. I also do go in with my beauty blender just to sort of, I don't know, work the product in. So yeah, that's how it looks. I'm gonna go in with my NYX concealer, and I'm gonna do it in the same way that all other YouTubers and bloggers and makeup artists do it. I'm gonna take a wee under my eye. So I don't take it all the way till my lash line. I just kind of blend it in and take it upwards from there. So how it finally looks. You can see that it's brightened, it's color corrected, and it's going to last like this all day long. All you have to do is set. Guys, there's going to be a back to, there's going to be lots more in back to the basics. So please like, comment, share, and subscribe, and stay tuned to my channel. Thank you for watching. Guys, please comment, share. Yes, comment, share, but no, wait. So I have been drinking this non-stop. Something fell. One video, one thing has to fall. Okay, I have been drinking this non-stop. It's over now because I have been drinking this non-stop. This is the Nesty Iced Tea in rose flavor. I'm such a fan. I love it. I just got my periods, and around the time that I'm supposed to get my periods, I am like a big giant blob of laziness. I hate working out. I want to eat only junk, and I'm so cranky. I don't even know why people are friends with me during this time. I'm so difficult.